Exclamation, everybody, and welcome to another channel update. This one for April 2016. It's been about a month since our last one, so we have some more numbers to go over here, as well as some more information about the channel. For those new to the channel, welcome. For those old veterans of the channel, you know what these channel updates entail. It's basically once a month I just wrap on what the channel's up to and what I've been looking at and some of the behind the scenes stuff, a little tiny bit of how the sausage is made, kind of deal, and then I usually play a game in the background that I don't otherwise play on the channel usually. And good things happen. And speaking of the game in the background this month is Lords of the Fallen. Yes, it is, as I've mentioned in, Cube Ramblings episodes, it is very Dark Souls-esque. But I actually surprisingly did well-ish, better than I thought I might. So that's a thing, I guess. But anyway, not talking about that. We're talking about the channel in general here. So from the last update that I did, we were at 1,384 videos, and we're now up to 1,425 videos on the channel. So that's a good market improvement. We're doing almost about 70s, very close to, 70 videos a month, something like that. That's a pretty interesting pace to be going at. And we went from 340 subscribers to 344, and 74,298 total channel views to 77,049 total channel views. Everything's on the up and up. Everything's going pretty well with that. Still very, very small channel in terms of YouTube. That's cool. I don't mind. I don't mind that too much. Not trying to expand very quickly. Usually when you start to expand, you start to get the problems of the larger YouTubers, right? Which is, that they have much larger issues than I ever will have as a small channel. So I try to... I'm in no rush. I'm in no rush to bring those things to the forefront. That said, I have been at the advice of commenters, and thank you very much to all of you for your comments on videos. I have decided to start change up my tags and my videos a little bit. Maybe add a few here and there. Try to make them a little bit more available to be shown up on YouTube searches and Google searches and various things like that, and that may or may not be working yet. We'll have to see. We'll see. I've been, like I said, just experimenting with additional tags and trying to get a few things going on there. So that's working out all right. I have been very, very quiet on Twitter. That's just I'm on again, off again when it comes to Twitter. I was trying to be a little bit more active on it, and it's been mostly just a here's all my videos, here's a better way, here's a way to see all the videos that went live more than anything else right now. So I do intend on trying to get back into the groove there. I was tweeting out on the days of SideQuest videos going up that giving you a little information that they're coming up ahead of time. But I sort of got out of that for a little bit too, so I'm trying here and there. I mean, given what we've seen, what I just saw about the financials of Twitter might not be around for much longer anyway. So maybe putting more time into that is not the thing I should do. But I will get back to that. I was trying to get into a pattern, into a rhythm with Instagram. Instagram is kind of a weird situation, right? It's like you upload via their mobile app. There is like an app that you have on your PC that you can upload screenshots from, which I've been using from time to time. But it's it's a third party app, and it's a little bit different and all that stuff. So Instagram's kind of a weird one, but I've been trying to I've been trying to remember to get into a pattern where I take a screenshot of whatever game I happen to be playing at the time and put it up every day, and it has not worked. I only managed to do one of those, but I promise I'm trying to get into a groove with that and see that stuff actually happen and try to try to get into a rhythm with that like I do everything else. I will be having more pictures go up probably in another day or two, because I think I have the Loot Crate Gaming for April coming in. I believe I saw the tracking stuff for tomorrow or Friday, so I'll probably have pictures of that as soon as I get it, so we'll have something there to look at too as well. Other than that, everything's going well so far. I've finished up a few recordings of a few games. Epistory, the final episode of that just went up the other day, or actually today when I'm recording this, I think. That was fun. I really enjoyed my time in that game. I need to find another game like that was really enjoyable, because that was a lot of fun. I did really enjoy my time in that. I did want to. I know Quantum Break took a little bit of a backseat to it towards the end there, because I just wanted to get that done. I wanted to get Epistory done. I liked it so much. So that's what happened with that. And then speaking of Quantum Break, I just recorded 2 more hours of that yesterday. So that will be going up on the channel. Probably it'll be back into a regular routine, regular pattern again on the channel as we're going forward here. That game, I really enjoy the story of that game. I really hate the combat in that game. I mean, it was really ticking me off last night recording that, because I was just sucking left and right, and it's just the controls are just bad. The combat just sucks. I just couldn't stand it. But I'm still working on it. I'm still playing it. I'm playing it really entirely for the story at this point. The rest I could just take or leave. So I've been editing it in such a way as to present more of the story than the combat. So if you're looking at those videos wondering why I've been cutting so much of the combat out, it's because I hate it. Absolutely, it is the worst thing ever, as far as I'm concerned. So I've been cutting that out in favor of just looking at a lot of the story and stuff in there. Plus, I've been dying a lot and restarting and everything else. It's been a rough go of it, but it's continuing forward, and I got through Act 3 just last night. Unfortunately, I couldn't watch the live action episode because it kept saying that there was no internet connection, even though there was. So I'm hoping that will. I left it paused on that, so I'm hoping I can maybe get that tonight and look through that, and then I'll have some more things for Act 4 when I can go and record that. So that'll be continuing forward. I don't know how many acts are in the game. It feels like we're pretty far into the game as far as the story goes, but it doesn't feel like we've actually gotten anywhere yet. So it's I don't know if it's going to be 5 acts or 6 acts. I don't even know. So we'll see on that one. This week I've been having a lot of side quest videos. There's probably going to be 3 side quest videos this week, hopefully. I know there's at least 2, because one went out today. I still have to record the third one. So I'm going to try to do that. That was just really this week thing. I don't know if I'll do that again next week or not. I have a long backlist of things that I've been looking at, and I just felt like I wanted to clear some of the list out a little bit. So that will probably go back to 2 episodes a week, if not less. I've been thinking of actually scaling that back down to 1, because it does take time away from doing some other recordings, and also it takes time to really get used to some of these games and to see what they're up to and what they're trying to do and be able to give a good impression of them. Really honestly, the reason I had 3 this week is because Mirror's Edge Catalyst surprised me. I was able to play that on a live stream, and that was I felt like I wanted to get that out as soon as possible. So the beta for that, I should say, the closed beta. So that's really what drove that this week. I still do want to get another look at Hitman and everything else, but I don't know if I'm going to do. I feel like I want to do Hitman as a series, because it is technically released now, and not as a one-off. So we'll see how that works. I'm not sure yet on that. I'm at a point now where I feel like I'm starting to finally clear out the schedule, and I want to see what else I want to go on to next. Crashlands is continuing. I am trying to wrap that up as soon as possible. I have, I think, a couple more hours of stuff recorded for that. And then I have, I think, what I think is might be the last, or close to the last push, last recording session maybe, that I need of that coming up. I've been prepping for it quite a bit. I've got all the pets now and stuff like that. I'm probably not going to complete get all the pets all the way up to their final forms and stuff like that. I'm probably not going to do that. And I may even leave a quest or two behind. I know that's sacrilege for me, but it's just, it's gotten to the point where the game is starting to wear thin on me a little bit. We've seen everything there is to be seen about it. Now I just want to get the rest of the story and sort of be done with it. I know that's a rough thing to say. It is a sandbox game, and you're supposed to enjoy it as a sandbox game, but I was enjoying it more for the quests than I was for the sandbox mechanics, and it's very, because it just has a lot of very grindy stuff to it, and that was my my big concern there with all the it was literally, let's put it this way, I have like 35 episodes or something like that, and they're about half an hour each. So we're talking maybe what, 2 into 35. That's let's see if I can do some math in my head here. 2 into 34 is what, 10, 15, was it? Like 15-ish, 25, 2, yeah, something 10, no, 30. Yeah, that's 15 would be 30. So 17, roughly. Yeah, something like that. Something like 17 and a half hours of actual footage. And I've played the game for close to about 50 hours almost. I think I'm very, very close to 50 hours on Steam with that. So that kind of gives you an idea as to how much I do off camera versus how much you actually get to see. And it's quite significant, with these sandbox games. And it's because it's so significant, I wasn't able to do more than that, like with Space Engineers and stuff. And Space Engineers takes a lot of that too. Like, it takes a lot of time off camera just doing some of the grindy stuff. But the amount that you do off camera versus on camera is significantly less there than it has been for Crashlands. So it's one of those things where I just kind of, at this point, I'm sort of ready to be done, and to clear that off the schedule. And then once that's done, I think I'll be back to Space Engineers again, getting back into that and trying to get through to some of my scripts and all those other things that I was planning on doing, and trying to get all that back up to speed again. And maybe I'll even dive down onto a planet surface on Space Engineers, maybe. Because I hear that they are a little bit more performant now, possibly. So that'll be good. I'd like to get back into that again. And then really I can only do one sandbox game at a time, because they do take so much time off camera to prep for and all that stuff. So that'll be coming back soonish once I clear out Crashlands. It's going to take a couple weeks, I think, to clear Crashlands out with the footage I have left. And then we've got a couple games I've been anticipating come up. Mirror's Edge, Catalyst will be coming up in May. I will definitely, based on how much fun I had just in the closed beta, I will definitely be playing that on the channel, because I played the original game, and this one, it looks to be a lot of fun too, at least story-wise anyway. Some of the open world stuff is not, you know, that interesting, but I still was enjoying myself quite a bit. So I definitely will be doing a series on that as soon as that is available. So that will take precedence. Obviously, we'll still have all the random stuff that goes along, like whenever Minecraft Story Mode's next episode comes out, we'll have that. Whenever Blues and Bullets' next episode comes out, we'll have that. If Telltale happens to release Tales from the Borderlands, you know, the second season of that, that'll be coming out. Well, if that happens to come out, I'll be doing that as well. So we have those little random things that are still continuing on that will pop up from time to time as well. And then talking about other things, Witcher 3. I know I put Witcher 3 on hiatus for a little bit. I do want to get back into that. That's another one that's... that one I enjoy. It's just... that one, I do all the things in that. It's not really grindy, per se. It's just, there's a lot of stuff to do. And I have a tendency to do all the things that I can, especially with, you know, side quests and stuff like that. So I can see that being, that was always, as far as my radar was concerned, that was always a thing that was going to be something that took me many, many years to complete. Much like a Skyrim Let's Play. You don't expect that to be done in like, 6 months or something like that. You expect somebody to take their time on it. And that's definitely what I'm doing with The Witcher 3. So expect that to come back within the next couple of weeks. Now the schedule's freeing up a little bit more. I also, I finished up, at least for now, Star Trek Birth of the Federation. I lost. It's, if you guys feel, guys and gals feel like you want me to do some more in Star Trek Birth of the Federation, please let me know. You can leave a comment here, you can leave a comment on that video, on any one of those videos, and I will certainly take that under advisement. I thought doing the 15 episodes was good, and I knew I wasn't going to win the first time around. I very rarely win in that game anyway, but I was I always wanted to just do at least one playthrough of it, just to show what it was like, and maybe, you know, shine a light on a gem of a game that maybe a lot of people haven't seen before. And obviously it's one that you can't really easily purchase anymore, but it's something that I enjoyed, and I really like to put it on there. So that is cleared up. Big Pharma has started, and I'm enjoying that too. That's going to be continuing for the near future, taking the 10:30 slots on Tuesdays and Thursdays. And I don't know what I want to do yet for the second slot on Tuesdays and Thursdays. I kind of want to get another RTS going, another strategy game going. I'm not sure what I want to do though. I was thinking I could possibly do Master of Orion, the remake one, the one that's still in early access. I could jump into that possibly. Since I've never played a Master of Orion game before, that would be interesting, and it would tie into some of the skills I got from the from playing Birth of the Federation with the 4X strategy stuff, so that might help a little bit. But the other things I was thinking of was I could possibly do I was thinking of maybe Freedom Force, even though that game I remember playing the demo for that. I actually own it now on GOG, but I played the demo of it many years ago when it was still fresh and new, and I got bored of the demo, so I don't know if I will still like the game now, or if I will like the game at all now, but I might try that. The other one that I was thinking of too, possibly was called Evil Genius, which was another one I played a demo of, and I really liked it when I played a demo of it, but it is a sort of kind of obtuse title a little bit. Like there's a lot to do in it, but it doesn't really necessarily tell you very well how to do things. So it could be a little bit of a frustrating thing from that perspective too. So I don't know. I'm kind of looking around a little bit. I've also, for the longest time, have been thinking of doing there was a space station management like strategy game, and I'm at a loss for words for the name of it. It was like the space station was like a donut shape and stuff, and it had like various aliens that you would manage and stuff. I remember I owned that. I actually owned that game, and I played it for a while and enjoyed it, but I remember hitting a wall with the game where I just didn't know what to do next and I couldn't figure it out. So I don't know if that is something that would work out well now that I'm a bit older and maybe I understand it a little bit better. Who knows at this point? But I do know that that one has some mods for the game. And in fact, I think the Steam version comes with a like an HD version of it, where you can get a full HD window or something. So I was also kind of thinking of that too. I don't know. And there's nothing that says it has to be a strategy game either. I've been also looking at some other games I could take in that I could put in there as well. I also want to possibly get back to Rebel Galaxy at some point and finish up the story of that. That's another one where it's going to take a lot of grinding that you have to do off camera, and then just kind of focus on the story of it, so we can see what's up with that. But I don't know. I'll see you on that one too. I was kind of I kind of want to do it, and but I don't know that it makes for good entertaining YouTube videos per se. It's one of those things where I feel like it'd be more entertaining as a live stream than it is as a video, but you never know. So that's that. And there was another one that was in that same category that Starpoint Gemini 2 is another one like that, where I haven't played it yet. I played a little bit off camera to get used to it, but I was having problems with it, I remember, with the control scheme. So and then Starpoint Gemini Warlords just came out, and I was just testing that out, and it was it crashed within 10 minutes of me launching it. So I that's probably not going to be recorded anytime soon either. But it's I don't know if I can wrangle the controls on that thing, because I really enjoyed Starpoint Gemini 1. But if I can wrangle the controls on Starpoint Gemini 2 to something that actually doesn't frustrate the crap out of me like it was, then maybe that'll be the next thing on the channel, because I do want to get another sci-fi thing on here at some point. I think those are pretty much bring you up to speed on some of the things that I'm thinking of. Live streams go. Borderlands, I do intend on finishing that up soonish. There's a couple of games that have come out in early access that I wanted to take a look at. Actually, this Friday, I wanted to look at Seraph. And I feel like I need to do that in a live stream because it has Twitch integration with it. So I'd like to do that, and then maybe I'll get back to Borderlands after all that is said and done. Because I still want to finish at least Borderlands 1, and then maybe I'll take a break and then do Borderlands 2 and whatnot. And I did say last month that I wanted to start maybe live streaming some more, but live streaming like as I'm recording things. I've been still looking into that. I don't quite have my system set up yet. I don't have OBS Studio set up quite yet. I have it installed, but I haven't quite figured out all the knobs, switches, and buttons yet on it, because I'm still using OBS Classic for all my stuff that is OBS related or recording with that. So that's where I stand on that. I'm hoping to get that to a point where it's a little bit where it's working a little bit better, and I'm getting good quality on it. Because that's really my concern, is that if I don't mind doing more live streams, like live streaming my recording sessions, but I just want to make sure that I don't adversely affect the quality of the video, either the audio or the visuals themselves. Not that I have the best quality in the world ever, but it's I know for live streams I have to kind of tone it down a bit because it's a live stream, and I also have been thinking, like, there's no way I'm going to do it with Twitch either, because Twitch, I have to push my streams down to only 30 FPS for Twitch, and, you know, because I'm not a partner there. So I figure if I do that, it's probably only going to be on YouTube Gaming that I do it on, maybe even Hitbox. Maybe I'll just do it Hitbox and YouTube Gaming at the same time, because they can both take 60 FPS and a better quality video out of it, and then that way I'll be able to, I won't have to dumb down the visuals or anything, or the quality, just because of Twitch. So hopefully, maybe I'll get something like that working at some point. I just have to get a little bit more comfortable, like I said, with OBS Studio and get that in place and whatnot. Or maybe I'll use this other program that I've been looking at too. There's another one that I have a beta for that I haven't actually done anything with yet that does something sort of similar. So I might even look at that one too. But anyway, in addition to that, I just wanted to talk one more thing about something else I've been thinking of. So I did a side quest video a while ago on Paladins. I did a side quest video just recently on the Overwatch beta. I do want to play these multiplayer games a little bit more. But I do want to show them on the channel too. Like, it's one thing to do a live stream of them, but I also kind of want to show... I kind of want to do videos of them on the channel. Now, a while ago, back when my channel was still... like, maybe a year into my channel or whatever, I used to have this rotating schedule where I would do a multiplayer game, and it was just once a week, and then it would be a different multiplayer game each week, and I would just kind of rotate them. I stopped doing that because it didn't seem like it was something that people were very interested in, because you kind of want a, though I like variety, you kind of want a series that is just that, and not, constantly changing, side quests notwithstanding. But, so I kind of stopped that because that just didn't seem like that was getting too much interest. And honestly, it wasn't the most exciting thing in the world either, because I was just kind of just recording whatever session I got. And, you know, it's a rough nut to crack, because from my perspective, I want to create something that's relatively entertaining. And when you look at like a multiplayer competitive game like that, A, I'm not a very competitive person, and B, I am not, you know, pulling off 360 no-scopes and all that stuff. And to me, I feel like those two things really are what make it interesting, is when you are when you're really doing high quality, you're high ranked player, I think that would make it a lot more entertaining to be, and or you're just a ragey ball of rage when things aren't going well. Two things I don't do. So I don't know. I want to play more Paladins. I want to play more Overwatch. I want to play Lawbreakers once I can gain access to it, which I hopefully will get picked to do access to it. And I want those to be able to... I want to be able to have videos of those on the channel. I mean, it's one thing, like I said, to do a live stream, but I do kind of want something else to show for it as well, like something on the channel. So, you know, if you missed the live stream or whatnot, you've got something interesting to look at still. So in order to do that, though, it feels like, you know, if I take Overwatch for an example, it feels like in order for me to be able to do a series on that, or at least do one-offs on it, you know, it doesn't have to be like a every week I do something. It could be like every 2 weeks or something like that. But just to do that, it feels like I would have to play probably for, you know, 3 or 4 hours at a time, and maybe only get 10 minutes of footage when I do it. That's actually worth, you know, that's actually entertaining to watch. So, and that goes for pretty much both of those games. So I'm still thinking about it. I kind of want to do it, but I also want to make it so that it's, you know, somewhat nail-biting and or a good, you know, a good watch. You know, not something like, oh, you lost again, huh? Well, that's the thing, right? It's like, you know, I don't mind showing some losses, but at some point I need to show some victories too, I think, because it really makes for a little bit more entertaining, I think, to be able to see a really good game. Like, I guess that's really what I'm trying to get at, is have a, you know, a close game or a tight game or a nail biter of a game or something like that, and be able to do those things. So, yeah, I do want to do something like that, but I want to, like I said, it's going to be very infrequent when I do it. But I do want to get back into those games, because I'm never going to be any like I really enjoy playing those games, but I haven't had a chance to really play any of them because I've been focused on so much on other videos and stuff. So, well, I think I've rambled on for quite a bit here. I think this is. Maybe I shouldn't have rambled on for quite so long here. Maybe this was supposed to be only a 20-minute episode, and I just kept on going here. But you know, this is what I tend to do. I ramble. I ramble a lot, and apparently a lot of people enjoy cube ramblings when I do it. So maybe that's part of the charm. Who knows? But anyway, that is your channel updates. My friends, for April, you can expect another one hopefully in May. Yeah, that comes after April, right? Yeah, that's how far gone I am right now. And thanks everyone for watching. Thanks for your support. Thanks for your kind words. Thanks for your attempts to help me actually be better at everything, better at a game, better at YouTube. I appreciate it a whole lot. And thanks so much for watching, everybody, and I will see you next time. Here, take this one.